This is my family right here. I'm going to take care of you. You take care of me. You feel me? Take care of this place. You do whatever it takes to win. Whatever it takes. You feel me? Everything you got. Let's go. We on three. One, two, three.
Put your hands up. Let's go.
With your wizard on track.
Beautiful morning. Get a sun in my morning, babe. Nothing in the water. Beautiful morning. Get a sun in my morning, babe. Nothing in the water.
Hello everyone, it has been a long time. My name is Sergeant Buttwhoop and welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to be introducing a new Madden rebuild for the channel. I know it's been a while, I've had a lot of personal stuff going on for the last few months that I haven't been posting, and I did start a Cardinals franchise, but I'm not going to continue that franchise. It just makes no sense for me to continue it, especially because though I don't have Madden 21, just because Madden 21 is literally the same game as Madden 20 and just made no improvements, I don't think I need to rehash all that with you guys. But also, I play Madden 20 on PC now, so I have mods. So I have a Start Today mod, which basically simulates us to exactly where we are in the regular season right now. It allows for gameplay to be a tad bit more realistic, progression to be a little bit more fun for me, and different things like that. You guys will see that all play out as we go through the rebuild. So we are going to be doing a franchise here with the Las Vegas Raiders. Of course, they just moved to Vegas this season. They've been playing games in an empty stadium. And let's get into the rules for this rebuild. So for one, look, I think I would just get bored playing all 16 games a season. So I'm going to be playing at least every single divisional game. I am still going to be playing other games if I feel like it. Obviously, if I don't have the time to post more than the divisional games, I won't be playing more than that. But if there's another matchup that I want to play, I'll be playing that one. So at least six games a year. At most, I would probably play like 8 to 10, maybe 11 if I'm really feeling it. The next thing is realistic moves only. Let's be honest, I do not have a ton of fun rebuilding teams fantasy style where we just, you know, trade for Khalil Mack and Aaron Rodgers in one season. That's not fun for me. This team is going to be built up through the draft and through realistic trades and realistic free agency acquisitions, you know. As we are with Las Vegas, are we an attractive free agency destination? Different things like that are things that I'm going to factor into how we make the decisions. And then we're going to be doing 4 years from 2020. So ideally 4 years. Obviously, maybe it might last a little bit less. Maybe it might be a little bit longer. But ideally, we get to 2023, 2024. And then depending on how the support and the views for the series are, maybe we do Sims of 2024 and 25. And then the last thing is we are using that franchise guys rosters. It's the best way to play the game, in my opinion. So that's what we're going to be doing. Now, let's go ahead and meet some of the mainstays of the roster. So, of course, we are headed by quarterback Derek Carr. Carr is in an interesting spot as a quarterback. He has on a decent contract, but the biggest thing is us trying to figure out if he's going to be the guy for the future, or if we're going to draft someone, or someone like Marcus Mariota, who's our second string quarterback, can come in and be a quality guy for us. Who knows? We're still not 100% sure on the quarterback position, so that'll be something interesting we try to figure out. At running back, of course, we have the Alabama project, Josh Jacobs, who's been great for the Raiders since being drafted. Look, I gotta be honest, I personally am not a big fan of paying running backs, so if he asks for a ton of money, we might not see Josh Jacobs stay on this team, but if he asks for a little bit less money, if he's willing to take a little bit less money, I honestly don't mind paying him. All he does is help us. Now, looking at the wide receivers, this is where some of the big factors that I'm looking to incorporate into this series come in. First, there is Henry Ruggs, the newly acquired first-round pick. At wide receiver, this guy's an absolute burner. I absolutely love Henry Ruggs personally. I didn't necessarily love the draft pick, but for what the Raiders are doing and for who the Raiders are, I respect it. And I'm hoping to make Henry Ruggs a major part of this franchise. As we know in real life this season, Chase Claypool and Justin Jefferson have been all the hype. Henry Ruggs has been pretty good too. And then of course there's also Hunter Renfro. He's going to be our primary slot receiver throughout this thing. I'm hoping that he continues his good development as he has in real life. At tight end, there's Darren Waller. He's been a superstar. He's been an absolute stud for the last year for this team. And then on the offensive line, we're hoping that Colton Miller can continue to put it together. Rodney Hudson doesn't regress too hard. And we like the rest of our guys, but it is an offensive line that could use some improvements here and there and some youth, really. Now, the weak link of this team is more our defense. Of course, we're going to start with the linebackers. This team did bring in Corey Littleton, who was one of the best pass coverage linebackers with the Rams. However, he's kind of dropped off this season. That being said, this linebacker core is still really good. Of course, there's Nick Kwiatkowski, formerly the former Chicago Bear, who's now on the team. He's been pretty good this season. And then we also have Raekwon McMillan, who could be a pretty interesting piece, especially if Corey Littleton continues to struggle. On the defensive line, we have Clelin Ferrell, the number 4 overall pick back in the 2018 draft, I want to say. Forgive me if I got that one wrong. But Ferrell is pretty good. He's kind of come into his own recently. So I'm hoping that he continues to develop to really prove up to that number 4 pick hype. Across from him, there is Max Crosby, the guy who gets no pressures but all the sacks. Hopefully he can continue doing that. Hopefully he can continue making Raiders fans think that he's better than Khalil Mack ever was. And then on the defensive tackle front, we have Maurice Hurst, who's pretty interesting. And then we have some other guys here. We might look to get a little bit younger here. And then another random throw-in name is Arden Key, who's another interesting piece on this defensive line. Looking next at the secondary, of course, we have Trayvon Mullen. He's kind of the main number one corner I want to develop here. And then some other interesting pieces are Damon Arnett and Amik Robertson. Robertson is a guy who I can hope can be a future nickel cornerback for us. However, it's going to be hard to get him playing time, at least for right now, because of LaMarcus Joyner. Really isn't that great outside, so he's going to be moving back inside and pretty much staying there. And then Damon Arnett is currently hurt, but hopefully when he comes back, he'll be able to take some of those snaps away from Nevin Lawson and hopefully progress. At free safety for right now, we have Eric Harris. He's kind of a placeholder stopgap type of guy. Definitely a position we're going to need to look at in the future. And then at strong safety, we have Jeff Heath and Jonathan Abram. I'm looking to start Jonathan Abram. He's the young guy. He's a good defensive backbone for the culture here. So I'm really hoping that he develops well for us. So that's most of the main pieces on the team that we're going to be focusing on developing throughout the course of this rebuild. And as for right now, our aspirations are we kind of want to be a scrappy little playoff team. We don't want to be caught in mediocrity. We want to, like, you know, really fight for an opportunity to get into the playoffs. Of course, this Raiders team came off of upsetting the Chiefs. Then they got blown out by the Buccaneers. Now here we've got another game against the Cleveland Browns that looks pretty interesting. But we're going to get more into that in the next episode. Looking at our draft picks is the last thing we're going to go over here. We only have one pick for every single round in the draft. Am I looking to make trades? I don't really know right now. I think we're going to figure out a lot of our trading in the offseason. I don't think we're going to be very active at the deadline, but if we do make any moves, you'll see all of that in the next video. Once again, as I said earlier in the video, I do like building through the draft, so who knows, we'll probably add some picks depending on where we end up to finish the season. Depends if we trade up, trade down, who knows. But anyways, that's it for the video. Thank you all for joining me today. It's good to be back. I hope that I can stay doing this consistently this time around, and I'm excited for this series. Let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you all in the next video.